6 years after assisting the Indonesian military in burning East Timor to the ground and butchering thousands of people, East Timor's militia are gathering again, this time in Indonesian-controlled West Timor. Still at their head is the man who led the militia in the killing, Yuriko Guterres. Sentenced by Jakarta to 10 years in prison for inciting murder and indicted for crimes against humanity by the United Nations, he's still free on appeal. Honoured and protected by the Indonesian military that created him, he knows he won't spend a day in jail.
Pada saat saya difonis 10 tahun, saya senang gitu. Saya senang dan saya malah tertawa. Karena sebuah putusan yang menurut saya sangat tidak fair.
This ceremony marks what's known as Integration Day, marking the lost dream of Indonesia's takeover of East Timor. It's the first time the militia have come together since 1999. Then, Integration Day was used to incite them to violence. Now they say they've gathered to commemorate their dead. There's no doubt who the star attraction is, and Guterres is happy to stand by his role as militia leader and the killers he commanded.
Dan saya yang masih bisa diberi kesempatan untuk hidup, maka saya bertanggung jawab penuh apa yang mereka lakukan di Timur Timur.
This mass meeting is a latent show of force by the militia to warn the East Timorese leadership. Many of the 339 men indicted by the UN Serious Crimes Unit are here in this hall, charged with multiple murders, rapes, and the forced deportation of thousands of East Timorese civilians. At the meeting, I couldn't help reflecting on the terror these people had caused in 99 and how they are now immune from prosecution. Here in West Timor, while his militia partners receive communion, Guterres, the man who orchestrated mass murder across the border, is now, it seems, preaching law and order. After the massacres in 99, the East Timorese were promised justice. 18 people were charged in Jakarta, all but two were acquitted. Those two are now free. In Dili, low-ranking militia have been convicted, but none of the leaders have been tried. The UN Serious Crimes Unit in East Timor closed this year. It reported to the Security Council that the process had failed. The UN Security Council is currently considering setting up an international tribunal to bring the perpetrators to justice. That would threaten the impunity of these people here and the Indonesian military who still command them. In early 99, I was one of the first two foreign journalists to speak to Guterres. Back then, the military introduced us to him. He was their creation. Now he's agreed to talk again, confident that he is above prosecution and will never face an international tribunal.
Saya hanya mau mengatakan bahwa kalau memang itu yang diinginkan oleh pihak PBB, termasuk Sanana di dalamnya, saya tadi katakan bahwa saya adalah pimpinan PBI, saya siap untuk diadili, memang saya sudah difonis, pada prinsipnya kami mendukung, dan memang itu yang sebenarnya diinginkan oleh kami sebagai pro-integrasi. Tapi kalau hanya kami saja yang diadili, saya kira PBB hanya menyediakan satu bom waktu yang suatu saat pasti akan meledak. Kalau terjadi seperti itu, saya ingin tanya, siapa yang harus menjadi penanggung jawab daripada bukan
hanya menjadi tanggung jawab pemerintah. Guterres says he doesn't care that he was sentenced to 10 years and the Indonesian officers in charge of the militia were acquitted.
Saya tidak merasa marah dan juga saya tidak merasa dendam dan juga saya tidak merasa benci terhadap siapa saja. termasuk teman-teman saya di Timur Timur. Dimintain pertanggungjawaban, karena peristiwa itu terjadi bukan hanya saya saja yang bunuh keluarga mereka, tapi mereka juga bunuh keluarga saya. Dan bahkan saya mau katakan di sini bahwa yang duluan melakukan pembunuhan adalah mereka. Sehingga saya melakukan pembalasan itu. Oleh karena itu kalau salah berarti bukan hanya saya saja yang salah, tapi juga Sanana juga salah. Oleh karena itu Sanana juga harus diadili.
And who should be punished for the 1500 people who were killed after the ballot was announced in September 1999?
Kalau kita mau fair ya, kalau mau jujur, yang harus bertanggung jawab adalah pemerintah Indonesia, pemerintah Portugal, dan PBB. Karena pemerintah Indonesia dan pemerintah Portugal melakukan kesepakatan 5 Mei, mengadakan jajak pendapat di Tinti, maka terjadilah peristiwa itu.
At this salubrious Kupang hotel, I found another key leader, Meiko Suarez. He once led the pro-integration movement and their militia in the enclave of Akusi, and has since worked for Indonesia's General Wiranto. He mocks the idea of an international tribunal.
Harus ada pengadilan internasional supaya orang Timur-Timur yang pro-integrasi itu militansinya tumbuh. Silahkan, coba bilang. The spirit to fight tumbuh.
Do you think the TNI is so confident of its own position at the moment that it's not concerned about any international pressure or prosecution?
Jadi TNI itu secara institusi tidak terlalu peduli. Orang-orang yang diadili, orang-orang yang dituduh melanggar HAM, mau masuk neraka, mau kemana, mereka tidak peduli.
The men Meiko and Yuriko claim to represent are languishing in refugee camps like this one in Nolbaki. The militia here used to attack foreigners who tried to enter. But now they and their families, 20,000 of them, are the only ones left, unable to return to East Timor because of the crimes they committed at the behest of their leaders.
Yang bawa kami di sini atau orang dari di tim sendiri tidak mungkin orang itu terima kami punya kesusahan. Paling-paling dia hanya senang di atas hidup menderitanya orang masyarakat.
We're now heading back towards East Timor. The camps extend right up to the border. This Indonesian soldier punishing a militia member shows who still control the militia here. On the East Timor side, there's now only 30 police at this crossing, replacing a battalion of Australians. Infiltration of the border by militia or Indonesian military would be easy if the order was given, if, for instance, their leaders were on trial in an international court.
Well, let me tell you, there is not one single member of the Security Council that is going to agree with that. And I, as foreign minister of East Timor, I'm not going to agree with that. There are other priorities, other urgent tasks ahead of us in East Timor. We want justice, but to achieve justice, we are not going through an international tribunal. We are going to work with the Indonesians, as we are doing now, on the truth and friendship, so that together we find the truth of what happened in 1999, so that Indonesian military officers or those involved in the violence, they can cooperate, step forward and apologize to the victims.
The pragmatic position taken by Foreign Minister José Ramos Horta and President Xanana Gusmão is unpopular in East Timor. In April this year, 10,000 people demonstrated for a week in Dili. The Catholic Church was blamed for organizing the rally. One of the main issues was the lack of justice for past crimes. East Timor's Prime Minister Mario Katiri is returning to Dili. He initially supported a tribunal, but pressure from President Xanana Gusmão and Foreign Minister José Ramos Horta forced him to change his stance, something he's reluctant to concede publicly.
So does your government support the establishment of an international tribunal?
I'm telling you, we are for justice. This is right. The reason why we fought for 24 years to free this country from occupation.
Then why does...
And at that time, many people really did support us. And we did it by ourselves. And now it's time for the international responsibility.
But East Timor, the East Timorese government, continues to say...
There is no government in the world that are looking for justice as the East Timorese government. No government in the world.
So, do you support the establishment of the international tribunal or not?
Maybe I'm not speaking good English. That's why you are not understanding me. Okay.
But Xanana and his key people aren't supported in Parliament on this issue. Opposition leader Leandro Isaacs led a vote in Parliament against Horta and the President, calling on them to stop declaring East Timor's opposition to an international tribunal.
Saya mau yakinkan 100% bagi televisi SBS bahwa 100% rakyat Timor Leste sangat-sangat mendukung anggota-anggota Parlemen Nasional Timor Leste untuk menyatakan bahwa pengadilan internasional harus didirikan untuk Timor Leste dan keadilan harus dihormati oleh seluruh lapisan politikus, jangan hanya orang Kosovo. Maaf, saya minta maaf. Karena kulitnya putih, berhak keadilan. Jangan orang Yugoslavia yang berhak. Tapi kami di sini juga memiliki derajat bentuk manusia yang sama di seluruh dunia.
Out here in Bakura Jail in Dili's eastern suburbs are 70 militia, the only ones tried and convicted by the East Timorese. 2 years ago, Marcelino Suarez was sentenced to 15 years in prison for crimes against humanity, including murder, carried out after this rally in 1999. This footage shows Eurico Guterres ordering his militia, including Marcelino, to attack the house of pro-independence leader Manuel Carrascalao and kill pro-independence supporters.
Komando pasukan negara mulai tanggal 17 dan seterusnya mencari dan mengadakan penangkapan. Kalau dia lawan, tembak kesempatan.
How do you feel that Eurico Guterres, the man who ordered you to do this, is still free and is still in Kupang and enjoying a very comfortable life?
Sekarang mereka dibebaskan.
Mereka sekarang bebas.
Malahan Gubernur Rabilo masuk penjara. Keluar lagi. Eurico Guterres katanya masuk penjara, keluar lagi. Apa ini undang-undang PBB ini benar atau tidak? Mereka itu adalah yang pondasi. Kami ini seperti batu pasir. Kenapa PBB itu berlaku semua negara? Kenapa PBB tidak tangkap dia di Indonesia sana, kasih masuk penjara? Kok berlaku hanya untuk kami kecil, untuk tangkap, kasih hukuman 15 tahun, masuk penjara? Kenapa dia itu apa?
With no international pressure, the tribunal will not go ahead, and those responsible for the killing in 99 will remain free to threaten East Timor's fragile independence.